Now let's talk about something you've been using this whole time, functions. Whenever you've used commands like rect or fill or text, you've been calling functions, and those functions have drawn what you've told them to do. What is a function, really? It's a collection of code that we've grouped together and given a name because we want to be able to use that bit of functionality many times. Think about rect. What does a rect do? It just draws four lines, right? We could just do that using our line function, right? And here we have what looks like a rectangle. But we realize that we kind of wanted to be able to draw a rectangle a lot of times, and it'd be really annoying to do the math every time to try and figure out how to draw a line from one corner to the next to the next to the next. So instead, we just made a rect function, and that function does exactly the same thing that those four lines of code did, but in much less code. So that's pretty cool, and rect is one of those functions that we've made available for all programs to use here on Khan Academy, but you can also make up your own functions to use in each of your programs. For example, let's say we're making a program and we want to draw Winston multiple times. Maybe because we're going to tell the life story of Winston and show him at every age in his life. So here's what our Winston drawing code might start off as. We have face X and face Y variables to store the center of the face, and then we draw the eyes and the mouth relative to those variables. Right now, the program sees the code, and it's not inside any function, so it just runs it, and it only runs it once. Okay, let's turn this into a function. To do that, we do it very similar to the way we declare a variable, because that's actually what we're doing. So we say var draw Winston, we give it a nice name, very descriptive, and then equals, but here, instead of writing a number or a string, we're going to write function, make sure you spell it right, and then empty parentheses, and then an open curly, and then a closed curly, and our semicolon. Okay, so what we need to do is put everything that we want inside our function in between the start and the end curly. So we're going to take all of this code here, put it inside our function, indent it nicely, and ta-da! So now what we have is we have this variable that's storing a function. So we've given a label to this block of code so that we'd be able to tell our program at any time, like, hey, find that block of code with that label and run it, right? So we're making this bit of code reusable. But now notice that we have no Winston anymore. We lost Winston. Where did he go? Okay, so what happened is that once we put this inside a function, we told our program, hey, here's a bunch of code that I want to be able to run later, but only when I tell you to run it. So we have to tell it to run the code, which means we need to call the function, just like we do with ellipse and rect and line. So we just write the function name, draw Winston, followed by our start and end parentheses, and of course our semicolon, and ta-da! We have a Winston. Okay, so I think it's cool, but you might not think it's cool because all we've done is made our program do exactly what it did before. Kind of silly, huh? The whole point of functions is we can reuse them. So let's do that now. We can just copy and paste this function call. Ta-da! Ta-da! Over and over. But it looks the same. Well, it worked. It's drawing multiple Winstons, but the problem is they're all in the same place. If we had x-ray vision, we could x-ray the canvas and see three Winstons, but I don't have x-ray vision, and I don't know about you. but we can make a small change to our function that will make it obvious. So you see face X and face Y, they're always 202 and 208. We can change this to using the random function, say like random from 50 to 350, and it'll generate a random number between those two, and we can do the same thing for here. And so then every time this function is called, it generates this new random number, and then if we press restart, we can keep getting random Winstons. So cool. Woo! Alright, so I think this is cool because it would have been a lot of code to write this if we didn't have it in a function. It would have been three times the amount of code. But it's still not as useful as it could be, because we probably don't want random Winstons. We probably want to be able to position Winston at specific points on the screen. So stay tuned, because we'll talk about how to pass parameters to our functions next. And then you'll be able to do exactly that.